So today we are going to replace the clutch master cylinder. As you can see, the clutch is all the way down because the main shaft of the clutch master cylinder snapped. So the process of removal will be best explained after I remove the pedal, because there are location of the bolts, two at the bottom and one at the top. Bottom bolts are easily visible. Here are the bottom bolts, one is this one and one on the side. The third one is on the top. So after these three bolts are removed, then the position of the master cylinder is easily accessible. So that's the broken shaft. So moving on to the next step now. So this is the master cylinder, the rear side of the master cylinder. As you may be able to see, here's a small metal clip which we need to unlock from pulling it from this side and pulling it backwards, so that we can loose the high pressure side of the master cylinder. And this is just the brake fluid, hydraulic fluid feed line. You just need to spin it and rotate it at the same time. But let's first remove the low pressure line. And a lot of brake fluid will come out because that's the way how it's supposed to work. Now we have a little better access towards that clip. I hope you can see that clip now. I'll zoom in the editing. Okay, feels like we can disconnect the high pressure line now. So we got the clutch pedal out completely, and mind that there's also a clutch pedal sensor which you need to unplug, but obviously when it got loose, the access is only available after that. So the third two bolt locations which I already show you was one and two. The third, which I was telling is not accessible for the camera, is this, the third one. So I'm really worried about how I'm gonna put the bolt back again on that thing. So, and here is our broken master cylinder. Here it is. You can see the shaft is broken, brake fluid dripping all over. And the rest of the shaft, it's not complete, a part of it is missing. So the rest is here. So how to remove this piece of the shaft? You can see there's a plastic clip here and two locks here, a lock here and a lock this side. So you need to press them and pull them outwards at the same time to release that thing. You need to save that plastic thing because you need to reuse it in the new master cylinder, and most probably it's better. Okay, I'll tell you along the way. We popped that clip out and this is how it looks. A lot dirty, so we'll open it just a little bit, and now you can pull the shaft of the old master cylinder out. I need to clean it. So basically you got the point what I'm trying to say. So everything removed, now we're putting everything back on. Make sure to remember two things. First, we remove the clip, we cleaned it out. We'll put a little bit of grease inside or here. Secondly, you need to transfer the clip from old master cylinder to the new one if you don't have one on the new one. So transfer that thing. So we need to plug it. It didn't came out easy. It's not gonna come in easily. Yeah. So now half of you will be thinking that I said we need to grease this thing, but you didn't. There is a spot to grease it because it's open. So here is that spot we can grease. So I'll grease it. I'm not going to show you the process of greasing this thing, but now the master cylinder has two states. One is collapsed state and one is expanded stitch. You are supposed to put master cylinder back on in the collapsed stage because it's much easier to put it that way. So now the only thing left is to put the master cylinder through here. We need to plug that thing. Yeah. Now it's how it's supposed to be. If you want to clean it out, it's a nice opportunity to do it. And putting everything back on again. Three bowls. So the old master cylinder is out and the new one is in clip and unlock position. I just need to push the lower high pressure line inside the cylinder and plug it back and also put the low pressure line on. So the last step will be flushing the air out of the system, and I'll tell you one more thing about that. So everything now bolted onto its final position. The old master cylinder broken shaft is here, and made a mistake. The last thing to do is to the pedal is still depressed. We need to make sure that the flow of the brake fluid starts to flow through the hydraulic system of the clutch master cylinder. So what we need to do is we need to bleed out the air. And one mistake that most of the people I have seen doing. Most of the people do, they start to bleed the clutch by their foot, which is not a good thing, because as we see, our master cylinder shaft was made out of plastic and it can go out very easily. So first few pulls till the time when you start feeling resistance, you need to do it by hand. After a while you will feel it, and you may also need to top up the brake fluid reservoir, because the clutch fluid reservoirs and brake fluid reservoir is common. So that's it, that's the only thing you have to do.